Hello everyone, this is the Tenda Nova MX15 Pro Wi-Fi 6 AX5400 Mesh System. I'm Eloy from Knowledge Sharing Tech. If you're new to my channel, please take a moment to subscribe. It only takes a second, it is free, and it will help my channel greatly. So in this video, I'll be unboxing this mesh system from Tenda, so for you to see what's in the box. Now I'm going to be talking about the specifications of this mesh system very quickly, and then I'm going to show you how to set it up, and I'll be performing a speed and range test. So let's start by unboxing this mesh system from Tenda. So let's open the box. And you have the three devices. So on each device, you have the power input, and then you have 3 gigabits ports. And this is a mesh button in case you want to add another mesh device that is not in this set to this system. And this is a reset button. On the front, you have an LED light here, and the three devices are the same, and any of the devices can be the main device. I'm going to show you this when I set up the system. Here we have an instruction manual. So of course you have 3 power bricks, and you have an Ethernet cable. So now let's go and set up this system. To set up the router, you need to connect it physically to your ISP's modem. So I connected the other end of this Ethernet cable to my ISP's modem, and now I'm going to connect it to any port of the router. And then you need to power on the mesh system. So plug in the power cord in your mesh system. So for now, power only one device of the 3 devices, and then give it a couple of minutes to set it up using the application. Now we need to install the Tenda Wi-Fi application on our smartphone. So go to your application store and then install the Tenda Wi-Fi app. And when it is installed, open it and tap on allow for everything, and then tap on agree. And now you need to connect to the Wi-Fi network of the Tenda device. So now you need to turn the router upside down to get the SSID that is on the back of the router with its password. So let's connect to this SSID. So here it is. It is Nova EM23A2. And you need to put the password. Let's tap on join. And now we are joined to this network. So let's switch back to the Tenda Wi-Fi app. And it continues automatically. So now let's tap on start now. And now it detected that my ISP has a dynamic IP. So tap on next. And next once again. And now you need to give your SSID a name. So of course, I'm not going to keep it on Nova EM23. So let's change it here. Of course, choose the name you want. I'm going to put it KS Tech for me, for Knowledge Sharing Tech. And for the password, choose a strong password. And if this check mark is selected, it means that the same password will be used for the management of the router. I'm okay with this, so I'm going to tap on next. So now the configuration of the Wi-Fi system is done. So now I'm going to tap on OK. So now we need to add the other nodes. We simply need to just power up the other nodes. So I'm going to power them up. So after you change the SSID, it is normal that you cannot connect to the device. So you need to connect your Wi-Fi network to the new SSID. So let's connect it to KS Tech. And here it is. And by the way, I powered the other nodes, so they should be operational in a couple of minutes. So notice how the 3 nodes were recognized, and the application detected that there's a new firmware version. So I'm going to tap on upgrade now. This way you see also how to upgrade the firmware. And it's important not to turn off the router or to disconnect it from the internet while the upgrading is taking place. Otherwise, the router can be damaged. So now the upgrade finished and the mesh system is ready to be used. Before talking about the specifications of this Nova MX15 Pro mesh system, I wanted to show you how you can place the nodes of this mesh system so to get the best coverage for your house. So I'm going to switch to screen recording and go to the Tenda Wi-Fi app and show you how to do this. So on your PC, open your web browser and go to this address, tendawifi.com. And here, put the password to log in to the administration page of Tenda Wi-Fi. And on the first page, you have your mesh system that is here. So you have the controller and you have the 2 agents. And the agents should always be on excellent connection. So you see it is green here, and on the left it says excellent. So if you have a connection that is fair or poor, try to replace the nodes so they get an excellent connection. And always place the controller in the middle of your house if you can. And the other nodes, place them from one side and other side of the controller. And if you have multiple levels in your house, place the controller on one level and the other two nodes, place them on the other level, like in a triangle mode. So the controller will be on top. It is like in the picture here. And then the others will be from one part and the other of the controller. So now let me tell you the most important specs of this system. So it is designed to cover a house of 7,300 square feet, which is really very good. It has, and I'm talking here about each node has a CPU that is Broadcom 1.5 gigahertz tri-core, and each node has six antennas. It has MU-MIMO and OFDMA. And it also covers a 160 megahertz channel, which is really very good. It is an AX5400 and it is dual band 2.4 gigahertz and 5 gigahertz. So now it's time to perform the speed test. But before performing the speed test, I wanted to divide the two bands, the 2.4 gigahertz band and the 5 gigahertz bands, so that I make sure that my PC and the devices that I'm gonna be performing the speed tests on are connected to the 5 gigahertz band. So to give you the most accurate result for the speed test and for the range test. So to do this, in the Tenda administration page, go to Wi-Fi settings, and then you see this unify 2.4 and 5 gigahertz button. You need to disable it, and it will propose to you a name for the 5 gigahertz band, which is KSTech_5G. So click on save, and now the settings are saved. The first speed test I'm gonna be performing is an internet speed test without any load on my internet connection. I have an internet connection of 120 megabits per second download and 20 megabits per second upload. And here the Wi-Fi mesh system is giving all the potential of my internet connection, and it is giving 130 megabits per second download and 21 megabits per second upload. The next speed test is also an internet speed test, but this time I loaded my internet connection, so I have two TVs streaming 4K movies, and I have also two iPads streaming full HD videos, and I have my Amazon Echo playing music. And here you notice that the speed drops a little bit, but not too much, and the Wi-Fi mesh system is coping very well with the traffic, and it's still giving 110 megabits per second download and 20 megabits per second upload. In this next test, I'm copying a large file from one PC connected to the Wi-Fi mesh system on the local network with Wi-Fi 6 to another PC also connected to the Wi-Fi mesh system with Wi-Fi 6. And the purpose of this test is to test the shear speed of this Wi-Fi mesh system. And here the copy speed is 45 megabytes per second, which is really very good. To perform the range test, I connected my smartphone to this Wi-Fi mesh system and I went into the hallway. I live in an apartment building and I kept walking until the connection of the Wi-Fi on my smartphone started dropping, and it kept going until the 120 yards, which is crazy good. And just before it cut, it was still getting a connection speed of 24 megabits per second download and 9.1 megabits per second upload. By the way, if you want to check out the Nova MX15 Pro Wi-Fi mesh system from Tenda, I'm going to leave an affiliate link in the description below. If you make a purchase using my link, I will gain a small percentage at no cost to you, and this will help my channel greatly. I hope that you liked this video and you found it useful. In case you did, please share it, subscribe to my channel, and give this video a thumbs up. I would really appreciate it, and this will help my channel also, and this way you'll not miss my future videos. I want to thank you all for watching. I'm Eloy from Knowledge Sharing Tech. See you in the next video.